Hello friends, welcome to Study Algorithms, and today we would be looking at greedy algorithmic paradigms. First, I would tell you the definition and show you what it means to be greedy. We would then see a real-life example and solve it using this paradigm. Going forward, we will see an example how greedy algorithms can be used to solve problems in computer science, followed by a demonstration. Let's get started. What do you mean by an algorithmic paradigm? An algorithmic paradigm basically means how you can approach a problem in order to solve it. There can be different ways to solve a problem. Check the link in the description below to know more about these algorithmic paradigms. In this video specifically, we would be talking about greedy algorithms. What do you mean when you say greedy algorithm? The word greedy means choosing the best for yourself. So how can we apply that to algorithms? How can you choose the best when solving the problem? At each stage, while solving the problem, we try to determine what is the best state for us, and then we proceed in that direction. A greedy algorithm would always hope that we would reach the optimal solution just by choosing the best optimal path at every instance. Before it gets further confusing, let me just show you a quick example of how a greedy algorithm actually works. Let us say you are given with some of these numbers. Now, I ask you, what is the largest single-digit number from this sample set? Your answer would be 6. Now, I change the question. I ask you, what is the largest two-digit number that you can form using this sample set? So, what do you do? Our approach would be, okay, let me select the largest digit I can find right now, and then I will go ahead. So, I select 6. Now, 6 is out of the picture. And now I'm remaining with 3 more digits. So what is the next possible largest digit? It's 5. So the number I form is 65. Now this is the largest two-digit number you can form using these 4 digits. What did we just do? We applied a greedy algorithm. We were greedy at every step starting from the beginning. When we had to select from 4 digits, we chose the largest number we could find. Going forward, we had 3 digits, we again chose the largest number and we moved forward in a hope that maybe at the end this algorithm would be optimal and we would get the maximum 2-digit number. So let me just expand this sample space and try to add more digits. So I add 6, I add 9, I add 2. Now I ask you, okay, tell me the largest number that you can form using all these digits. I would just go ahead and apply the greedy algorithm, and which would work something like choose the largest number 9, then go ahead and choose the next largest number 6, then go ahead and choose the next largest number 5, then 3, then 2, and then 1. So this is the largest 6-digit number that you can form using these digits. What did we just do? We just used a greedy algorithmic approach to solve this question. So, we can say that a greedy algorithm basically consists of 4 steps. Number 1, choose the best possible solution that you can find at the current step. Number 2, if that solution is feasible, add it to the solution set and move on. Number 3, if that solution is not feasible, reject that solution and move ahead and never consider it again. Number 4, just keep on looping through this process until and unless you are exhausted of all the options. Once this algorithm is complete, you would hope that you are reaching to the global optimum solution. I know that this was a very, very, very basic example of how a greedy algorithm works, but this was required so that you are familiar with the concept of a greedy algorithm and what do I actually mean when I say choosing the best for yourself. Let me show you some real-life example. You may not realize, but you use greedy algorithms in day-to-day life. A good example would be playing games. What do I mean by that? I believe most of you must have played the game Monopoly. I've got some Monopoly currency over here for you, and let me adjust my camera angle a little bit. In a game of Monopoly, you have currency of different denominations. So, let us say you are the banker. And someone asks you, okay, give me 500. As a banker, your task sometimes is to provide the player the least number of currency notes that you can give. You wouldn't go around giving him 500 notes of 1, or let's say some 5 notes of 100. Maybe that can be a requirement, but the minimum number of currency notes that you can give to the user would be 1, and you would straight away give it to him. When does a greedy algorithm come into the picture? Just like Monopoly, in most of the currency, if I ask you, let's say, give me 560 rupees. The best way to give the minimum amount of currency notes is start with the highest currency note that you can find and go on to the bottom until you can't find any other currency notes. What do I mean by that? So let us say you have to give 560 money to somebody. The biggest note I have available here is 500. Can I use that? Yes. So I take it out over here. Next, I still need to give 60 to the user. Now, I cannot give a 500, so I discard it. Going on to my next available option, 100, I cannot give a 100, so I discard it. Now, I reach 50. So, since 50 is less than 60, I take up one of this. I have collected 550. Can I give another 50? No. So I discard it. Can I give a 20? No, I discard it. Can I give a 10? Yes. So I take up this note and put it over here. I got the sum total as 560, and this is how my greedy algorithm was able to give the currency of 560 in the minimum amount of denominations possible. Let us do one more example really quickly. This time, let us take up the amount 1432. Let us start. What is the biggest denomination available? It is 500. So can I use it? Yes. That gives 500. I can again use it. 500. I have 1000 available. Now, I need to give 432. I cannot use denominations of 500 to give 432. So I remove this, or as I would say, reject it. Now, I am left with 432. Can I go ahead with 100 notes? Yes, I can. So I take out 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'm left with 32 now. I cannot use 100 anymore. Can I use 50? No. Can I use 20? Yes. So I take out a 20 note. Now I'm left with 12. I cannot use 20 anymore. I'm left with 12, so can I use 10? Yes. So I take out one note, discard it. Can I use 5? No, I discard it. Can I use 1? Yes. I take out two currency notes. So this is the minimum amount of currency notes that I would be required if I need to give the player a sum of 1432. So these are some simple ways you can use greedy algorithms in day-to-day life. So the next time you're handing out change to a local shopkeeper or some of your friend, just know that you're using a greedy algorithm. But since you're here, you might also be interested to know how a greedy algorithm could solve a problem in computer science. So let's have a look at it. Activity scheduling problem is one of the most popular problems that can be solved using a greedy algorithm. So let us understand the problem statement first. You are given a certain set of activities. In this case, you have activities ranging from number 1 to number 6. And all of these activities last from certain duration. For example, activity 1 lasts from 00 hours to 6 hours. Activity 4 lasts from 5 hours to 7 hours. Activity 2 lasts from 3 hours to 4 hours. Now, given this time frame, I want to do as many activities as possible. Also, when you are doing one activity, certainly you cannot do another activity simultaneously. What I mean by that is, if you pick up activity number 1 and put it on your schedule is now blocked from 0 hours up to 6 hours. That means you cannot pick up activity number 2, number 3, or even number 4 because it starts at 5. At the most, you can pick up activity number 5 and put it on your schedule between 8 and 9. You can imagine that there can be a lot of permutations of how you can go about doing these activities. In our problem statement, we just need to find an optimal way to perform the maximum number of such activities. How do you go about doing that? Since we are talking about greedy algorithms, we first need to determine which activity do we need to choose at every step. So one of the approaches would be to choose an activity that starts at the earliest. So if I go with this approach, then I would be picking activity number one. I put it on my schedule. Now I cannot pick up any other activity from the range 0 hours to 6 hours. So what I'm left with is only one other activity, that is activity number 5, and I put it on my schedule. So this gives me a total of 2 activities. But even you might feel that this is not the optimal solution. So we try to explore other ways how we can go about picking an activity. What you need to think here is that how do you define your greed? To perform the maximum number of tasks, I can also choose activities based upon their finishing times. So if an activity finishes early, the more time I would have to complete other activities. So what if I sort all these activities in the order of the time that they're finishing? Let me just quickly go ahead and sort them. I just sorted all of these activities such that they are ending earliest. So my activity first ends at 2, then at 4, then at 6, then at 7, then at 9, and then at 9. Now let me try to be greedy, and now let me try to put all of these activities in my schedule. So what is the first activity that comes to my mind? It is activity number 3. I take up this activity and put it in my schedule between 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Next, my schedule is empty, so I would see what is the next activity I can pick up. That would be activity number 2. I take up this activity and I put it again in my schedule. Going forward, my schedule is empty from 4 up till 9. Now you see that although my next activity ends at 6, but I cannot pick this up because I already have activities that I have been doing between 0 to 6. So I would just completely get rid of this activity and not think about it anymore. The next activity that I can pick up is activity number 4. It runs from 5 to 7. So I take this up and put it in my schedule. Going forward, I see one more activity, and that is activity number 6. But this collides with my previous activity, and hence I would be ignoring it. The last activity that I can pick up is activity number 5, and it runs from 8 till 9. And I put it up in my schedule. So, with this approach, I was able to do a total of 4 activities, and this is my answer. Now, this is a case where greedy algorithm worked for us, and at the end, we ended at an optimal solution. But the important thing here is that choosing the greedy approach is the basic crux of a greedy algorithm. Think like this: if you're being greedy in the wrong direction, you wouldn't succeed in your goals. So, determining what is your greedy approach could involve some maths and some science to eventually prove that this would lead to a global optimum solution. I hope this video gave some insights on how you can use greedy algorithms to solve problems. A text-based explanation to this can be found using the link provided in the description below. Let me know in your comments how you use greedy algorithms to solve problems. Thank you.